Hello, property nomads. Hope you're well. Today's episode, we're going to be looking at one big no-no when it comes to insulating both your homes and also your rented properties. This comes from two people. It comes from number one's mortgage broker, number two, from personal experience, from what I've seen as I go around doing energy performance certificates. But before we get into today's episode, just to let you know that our friends at Progressive Property are conducting their multiple streams of property income. It's completely free to attend. It's in Peterborough, which is about an hour north of London. It's a three-day training event, completely free, Friday the 20th to Sunday the 22nd of October 2023. In order to get your free ticket, if you listen to this on the podcast, just go to the show notes. The link will be in there. If you are watching this on YouTube, just look in the description below. Loads to learn, all sorts of different property things to learn, serviced accommodation, rent to rent, various strategies. It's a cracking three-day event. Aaron and myself have done it multiple times. Highly recommend that you get over to Peterborough with our friends at Progressive Property. As I say, link is in the show notes. So getting back to the big no-no, what I'm going to do is going to share screen and let's have a look. So this comes from, this is money. And the question is, my daughter's house has spray foam insulation. Can she get new, well, that's badly worded, but it should be, can she get a new mortgage? So recently, what you can do for your home or for the properties that you own is when it comes to roof insulation, normally you get the glass wall or brown wall, roll it out, that sort of stuff, put it in between the joists, voila. That is your bog standard roof insulation. You might have Kingspan or various other forms of boarded insulation as well. But one thing that is becoming increasingly popular is spray foam insulation, and what that is. Pretty much like Ron Seal does exactly what it says in the tin. People go up into your roof, into your loft space, and rather than lay a bunch of insulation down at joist level, they will use this spray foam and spray in between the rafters. Now, this is a massive no-no as far as I'm concerned, because number one, from an energy performance certificate point of view, yes, it can help to improve your rating, fine. But in terms of the long-term effects on the home, what has happened with spray foam insulation in the past is that where there might not be enough room for the insulation to breathe up in the loft, or all the timbers have been covered, et cetera, over a long period of time, that can affect the timbers in the roof. And if you're allowing moisture into those timbers in the roof, again, over a long period of time, the timbers are going to start to rot and you are potentially faced with massive issues on your roof. This is why I say this is the one big no-no when it comes to insulating your home. Do not do spray foam insulation. Like anything, if it's not done properly, it could have serious consequences for both your home and your tenants. Should you decide to go down the route and do this in your portfolio. So on this article, someone wrote in to a mortgage broker, and the reply from a chap called David Hollingworth was that with mortgages, you need to satisfy the lender. And two things that you need to do. Number one, the borrower needs to meet the lender's requirements. As we've said, or Mark Chan of War Financial has said many times before, the lender's requirements are always different. So some lenders will say one thing, some lenders will say another, et cetera, et cetera. The second element is that the lender will want to be sure that the property will be a suitable security for the mortgage. Now, that pretty much means that is the property in good working order? Is everything as it should be? If not, then the mortgage company won't proceed to offer. Normally, you'll get a valuation, and the valuer will go round and they will have a good look normally, and then they'll send a report back. One thing that is coming up quite a lot recently is foam insulation in the roof. And a lot of lenders, mainly high street lenders, are rejecting properties that have foam insulation in the roof. So this is the other reason why I'm saying to you, it's a massive no-no when it comes to putting foam insulation in your loft space. Just to recap, number one, it could have serious long-term consequences on the structure of the roof, and specifically the timbers in or on the roof as well. Secondly, we're starting to see that more and more mortgage companies are starting to reject homes that have foam insulation in the loft. What the article does, rather than read all through it, so it summarizes again what I've just said. What's the problem with spray foam insulation? It puts it more subtly than I did. It can potentially cause problems for property if it traps the condensation in the roof space. So that's normally going to happen when it's been installed incorrectly. And again, it just goes through roof timbers beginning to rot, property can't breathe properly. And that can have long-term consequences. And again, lenders will be looking at that, and they sometimes just like taking the easy option. So if you've got foam insulation in your loft, chances are they're probably not going to lend on it, or they might require more structural surveys, or a structural survey, or more in-depth roof surveys to be done. Of course, that's going to add a cost to you, and you've got to evaluate that when you look at your mortgage process or buying process. Not all lenders are going to sort of reject it, but again, it's just going to create complications. So there we are. That is a big no-no. The one big no-no. Do not put, in my opinion, do not put foam insulation in your loft. It's not good for your own home, especially if it's not done properly. Secondly, not good for your portfolio as well, because it could have very long-term consequences. As you mentioned at the start, get yourselves down to Progressive Property for the multiple streams of property income. The link for that event is in the show notes. It's a great 3 days. Friday the 20th of October to Sunday the 22nd of October. We've got some really exciting interviews coming up as well. So watch this space on Property Nomads. We'll see you in the next video.